four ridiculous, easy ways, ridiculously easy ways that you can start to transform your health right this very second. Today on hashtag Naptime Chat. So I'm Kathy Callahan. I come live, if we haven't met before, in case I have anybody who's on here that I haven't met before on my personal page, every day at 1:30 during nap time for my kids and connect with mamas and friends and share some simple things that y'all can do to start improving your life, your health. Today we're going to talk about four super simple things you can do to start transforming your health right now. What are you guys doing today? It's Thursday, April 30th. So if you're watching this on replay, hashtag replay below. I'm going to give you four fun things. I think these are simple. I think you could literally get off this live right now and do them. I'm sitting in my favorite massage chair ever, totally on a side note. But I'm like, where can I go separately than I always go live at? I got this baby for 50 bucks at Swap and Sell on Marketplace. Do y'all shop on used stuff? I love used stuff. All right, four ways you can start to transform your health right now. If I share something and you do it, drop in the comments below that you do this and you love it and how well it is helping you. Number one, this one is so simple. Y'all, breathe. Just breathe. Don't just breathe, but breathe deeply. So it can have a huge effect on your health if you just simply breathe. Now, is your life crazy? We have a lot of chaos in our home all the time. It says, bless this mess. It's always a disaster, either mentally or physically around here. And I find myself sometimes just taking a deep breath. Do y'all do that? So the benefits of deep breathing, it will increase overall cellular health. It helps your brain function and it helps your general sense of well-being. Who has an Apple Watch? Drop me in the comments below if you use the Breathe app. You can set this up where your watch will actually remind you to take 1 minute of breathing. I think it's every hour. I don't know how Siri knows, but somehow at the exact moments that I need to take a deep breath before I lose my mind, my watch taps me and tells me it's time to breathe. So get an app on your phone. That's a great way to do it. Or just simply remind yourself to take some deep breaths and breathe more deeply. Number two, get hydrated. Anybody can do this. I know that if you have been watching any of our previous lives, we are on day 11 of our 14-day water challenge. Is that right? Day 11. So my goal is to drink 64 ounces of water every day. One easy way to do that is just start your day with water. I'm keeping this baby at my bathroom sink. So first thing in the morning, I'm remembering to do that. So chronic dehydration is the root of so many health issues, including fatigue and just a general sense of like feeling not well. I have heard amazing testimonials from people coming out of the water challenge groups of just simply adding water. So y'all start breathing more deeply, drink water. You can start transforming your health right now. Do you know that I said four things and I might actually have five things? Lucky you. All right. Move your body. Now, if you watched Naptime Chat yesterday, we did a 5-minute workout and I shared that often I don't have time. Okay, first of all, everything's closed, right? So who used to go to the gym but you can't anymore? So I used to have more time, like when I could put my kids in the playroom and I could spend a 30, 40 minute workout. Now, like, no, it's not happening. The short amount of time that they're actually resting, I do my Naptime Chat and I work my business. So I don't have a lot of time outside of that. So things you can do is go take a light walk, stretch your body, climb some stairs. Who's working right now? If you are working, it's recommended to take two breaks of 20 minutes to 1 hour a day, or two breaks during your work day of 20 minutes to 1 hour. So if you find yourself sitting for like 8 hours in a row, a lot of us aren't doing that anymore. So get your body up and moving. The fourth one is pretty cool. I like this. This is something I hadn't really thought about. So breathe deeply, get hydrated, move your body, even if it's just simple stretching, if it's getting out there and walking, or if you can do the 5-minute workout we did yesterday for Workout Wednesday, or if you can get in your back into your full gym routine and you can commit to that at home and find the time, great. That's the best. Number four is actually to eliminate the worst offenders. Now, this one's very interesting to me. Child, you're loud. You don't care. Evan. What? Dude, you're loud, man. Do you have like a, do you have like a, do Do a side button on the side of your loudness. He's loud. You can't control it. Laughter is actually one that I almost put on here, but I didn't because I was like trying to get it down to not so many. Okay, eliminate the worst offenders. There's actually three places that you can start looking at if you're including some of these worst offenders in your daily routines. If you can start eliminating some of these, you're going to instantly start transforming your health. Number one is the things that you use daily. How many of you use like sweeteners or condiments or include extra snacks that are not good for you? One of the biggest health changes that I made, I guess a year and a half ago now, was to get rid of artificial sweeteners. And y'all know, if you know me very well, that I used to love Diet Well Cherry Pepsi a whole lot. Like, she was my BFF. I carried those 20-ounce bottles around like crazy. And I was much more willing to eat my calories than I would be to drink them. So I drank everything that was artificial because it tasted good and I didn't want to waste calories on drinks. I really wanted to get rid of the crap sweeteners. And so that is a big thing you can start to do right now to transform your health, is just looking at that extra stuff that you're putting in that might be like bad chemicals, harmful chemicals, or artificially sweetened, and see if you can start trying to find some more natural options. If you need help with natural drink options, y'all know I can hook you up there. You can just ask me for the drinks that I've transitioned over to. Take a look at the products you use on your entire body. Here's the three top offenders there: body creams, laundry detergent, and perfumes. Okay, so if you're looking to transform your health and you want to make some quick changes, start looking at what's in your body creams, your laundry detergent, and your perfumes. Those are the top three offenders for things you use on your body. And start to look at things that are more natural. Get familiar with what ingredients are. Find out about common ingredients that are used in a lot of products. Educate yourself there. And then another section of the eliminate the worst offenders is stuff you use in the shower. Y'all, I learned this when I was researching for today. Did you know that the reason why the shower stuff that you use is such a big deal? Because when you're in the hot shower, your pores open up. And so it's most important to really consider stuff you're putting on your hair and on your body in the shower, because then it's even getting more into your body. Never thought about that before. So where would the big offenders in the shower be? Your shampoos, your conditioners, and of course your body washes. So start looking for more clean and green options there to transform your health. Okay, that was technically four. The last one is super simple. Stay inspired, stay connected, and get connected with some kind of community. If you are trying to make some health changes and you like what we shared today, breathe deeply, drink more water, move your body however you can, eliminate those worst offenders, and get connected with people who are like-minded. Because the one of the biggest things is when you are making a transformation, it's really easy to not keep drinking your water if you're not connected to other people that are drinking their water. So we have our little water challenge group because we keep each other accountable. If you are trying to move your body a little bit more, stay connected with people who have similar goals. Being connected to a community will help you stay inspired, stay accountable, and keep you on the right track for you and your health goals. So that's what I had to share today. Did you like it? Did you like my Transformation Thursday? Find one thing you can do right now. Progress over perfection, right? Something small. Baby steps, eat the elephant one bite at a time. Y'all know that, right? How do you eat the elephant? One bite at a time. All right, I'm going to my dad's, because guess what? My kids are not here right now. It hasn't happened this whole quarantine. It has not happened, but mama was losing her cool. I was breathing deeply and it wasn't working. So I ditched them for a little bit. I'm gonna go pick them up and bring them home to put them down for nap time chat. And I will see y'all tomorrow at 1:30 Central Time. Very soon, I'm gonna be announcing our winner from the TikTok challenge. If you were in that, you have a chance to win a $25 gift card. So I'll be announcing that after two. If you haven't voted yet, go to my profile and vote on those videos. All right, guys, bye for now.